Hey guys, it's MagSync with Convertible Turtle Gaming again. I'm going to do some more Crypt of the Necrodancer this morning. Just got off my shift, kind of bored. Figured, hey, I can do this pretty quick. Have some fun, and then head out to bed. So probably looking at maybe half an hour, 45 minutes, give or take. And then that'd be probably the extent of this. But as you can see, haven't actually done anything since last time we played. Nothing off camera, no tricks here. Haven't got zone 2 unlocked to save my life, so we're gonna go back to zone 1 and see how bad we can do it again. If you look in the description, guys, you'll notice that I don't have my monitor hooked up yet for my second one, so as far as chatting along today, probably not gonna happen. But I might alt tab during deaths or something. That's kind of what I'm thinking. Just to flip over, say hi. Definitely warm up. Don't think we get anything for one. Doesn't look like it.
Hello.
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 Quick hot tab to say hi to anybody that's here with us. If anybody. Nope. All right. And back to we go. Oh, that's kind of neat. That lock had an actual kind of glint to it. Makes me wonder how many of those I've managed to totally pass up. Ooh. Wow. Shop keeps like in a secret passage. We got 12 paltry coins, so at least the torch will help. Broadsword. That's pretty awesome. I've never had the miner's cap, so... Man, there's whole lot of them I haven't gotten to. And that chest is going to be one of them. Better than just being able to see everybody. So we'll just stick with that. Almost got the last bit of coins there. Oh well. Still not really good at fighting dragons, it seems. Turning to the lobby. We got 4 gems this time.
Hello.
So your lunge for double damage. Not sure what that means. Slow, strong dig. That sounds horrible, actually. Don't know exactly what that means. But finding +1 defense in the dungeon sounds like it'd be a winner. So we'll go with that.
Hi.
Let's see if we can pay the janitor to do anything for us. Alright. Weep. torch was kind of what we wanted. But no, it's okay. So when you get an upgrade to an item, apparently it takes the other item out of the world. So there's that. Okay. So we'll pop over and see what we got going on YouTube chat. Still nobody there. That's okay. We got probably, another 20 minutes maybe, guys, before we're going to call it quits. Again, this is kind of one of those things. Just got in the office, from home to the office, and thought, hey, I'll play some of this. It's one of the things I actually really like about the game. Hey, spear is awesome. One thing I did find out about this that I've noticed is the blocks. When you're above them, occasionally you'll see where you can kind of see the bottom of the block, indicating that you have a way to go a bit below it. Sure, we'll put that in our pack. I guess we can't do that in our pack. That's not an actual weapon pack, because it's on a holster. It just costs us way too much money. Much rather have the spear, and that's my fault. So like, over here, if you guys see where we got these blocks, you can kind of see the bottom, means that something should be underneath here, I think. Yep. Oh wow, there's the pet holster. Oh, if I either get the satchel or the holster. Well, I paid for the freaking dagger. So, wolf. Shopkeepers are awesome. That. Ooh, secret shop. Ooh, that's kind of nice. So now we hit like a mule, I guess. Ooh, there's a bomb. Oh wow, I kind of like one-shot minotaurs. I won't lie, that was nice. Oh, and I can break open barrels. Oh yeah, this will do nicely. See all items, or see all enemies. And extra defense. Sounds good. I didn't know exactly how that would be. But it was worth a shot. So red up here it says. Got a funny feeling this one's going to cut to worth in a second.
Yep.
Alright. Everybody dance. Dragon, been the bane of our existence in this game for pretty much the whole entire time I've played. Only one I've ever killed was in the training mode. So, take that as a super awesome. Lack of a shop on this floor is really kind of sick. Unfortunate. Oh, wait. This might be something. So here goes boss.
Coral Riff.
Hey, we've been to this guy before. We kind of know what he's doing. He's doing things in the water. So before we go, we're going to go over here. We skip the beat, which is unfortunate. Hey, Jasmine. Thanks for joining chat. If you've left already, sorry about that. I'm actually kind of one monitor right now, so kind of alt-tabbing and stuff. But we're about to do a boss battle here in this game and see what things kind of go on. And, it's a boss I've come to before. Things didn't quite go what I hoped they would. Oh, that's unfortunate. Boy. Let's see here. Oh wow. So, still not sure what his mechanic is, but I do know gigantism apparently kills him really good.
Dad was always coming and going on his adventures. But this time he seemed more excited. He said he'd found it, some great treasure.
When I was older, I found the notes he left behind. Directions to a graveyard.
Uncle Eli tried to stop me. But Dad had been gone for 2 years. I had to find him.
So beat a boss, get a cutscene, get a return to lobby. Oh, yeah, we'll return to lobby.
New character unlocked.
That's cool. Character unlock. And like every other type of roguelike in the world, we get greeted with all of our stuff going away. But, you know, that's the way these games go. Oh, yeah, Jasmine, it's absolutely fun. Every time I get to the lobby, either by death or win, I alt-tab. That's actually the first time I've beaten a level. So, first time I've alt-tabbed after coming to the lobby from a win. If you like any kind of dungeon exploration games, this is definitely a fun one. It's actually playable with a Dance Dance Revolution controller, which I think is kind of cool. Down here, there's actually a dance pad mode, which makes the game easier, it says. I think it just makes the timing a little more forgiving. Because you actually play this with just four buttons, up, down, left, and right. You actually move to the beat of the music. And as you're doing it, the game improves. Spending diamonds. That's kind of important. The currency in the game is diamonds. And you actually get those to stick with you as you go through the dungeons. The gold goes away, though. Is it be it by death or be it by anything else? Oh, more upgraded stuff. Okay. I'm still not sure how I feel about the rapier, but it seems to want to make me have it. We'll go over to the magic guy and see what he's doing, Merriman.
Hello.
Plus one heart, fewer enemies. That sounds like something we want. So, where it says these items will show up in chests, there's chests in the dungeons, and those items are part of the loot table now. So, we're going to go to Zone 2 and see what we do. Mushrooms. Okay, not sure what half these enemies do. Oh, but I do know... Minotaurs I'm pretty familiar with. They run, they hit a wall, and they get up. And wow, that was all it took. 0 points, so we'll probably go quicker start in a second. We'll return to the lobby just to kind of go back and say hey. Totally understand, Jasmine. This is kind of an impromptu thing, so... got home from work, decided to stream a little bit, and then go to bed. So that's kind of what I'm going to do in about, probably 10 minutes. So I'm going to try Zone 2 again, see what happens. Because that was interesting. I like finding enemies that I have no effing clue on what to do about. Which is one of the really cool appeals of this game in general is... Oh yeah, we're going to quick replay that again. So those... That was interesting. So even the stage is out to kill me in this level. That is really good to know. Alright, next level. Like two hands in this game, apparently. Blood broadsword. That's all that counts. Alright, go back to the lobby. See if we have anything to buy with two gems. I doubt it.
Hey.
But hey, we have a personal best today. We actually made it to zone 2. Not bad for a little kind of quick fire setup that we had going on today. And.
Hello.
Hey, we can even see all the zone 1 enemies. I still got one that I haven't ever found at all. So, reason to play zone 1 again. And let's see here.
How's it going?
That's going pretty good, man. Yeah, that's one thing that's kind of neat with the NPCs here. Oh, wow. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Guys, the wall mimic. That was interesting. Let's let you practice training against them. But all it does is spawn them. So the wall basically goes to the music. So that's good to know. Even if you know they're there, there's no hitting them with the thrown weapon. So the next question I have, of course, I can throw a weapon at them after they've animated. Interesting. But yeah, guys, that's another day of Crypt the Necrodancer. It's been about half an hour. And so we're going to go ahead and call it quits. It's unlock zone 2, so way cool. And, yeah. So like, share, comment, subscribe. I know this has been smaller streams than usual, but I'm still getting everything sorted out with the new rig and everything, guys. So apologize for that. Appreciate you working through this with me and, you know, waiting on me on that. But, yeah, we should have something streaming this Monday. I'm not sure exactly what, but we'll find out. And, just kind of keep an eye on the channel. We'll see what it is and see what's posted then. So take care, guys. Good morning, good night, no matter where you're at, and have a good day.